So guys, welcome sa ato ang another installment sa ato ang TNS3, which is Geology for Civil Engineers, no? Then for this chapter 5, so we will be discussing about the atmospheric sciences. So medyo it takes a lot of time para sa kuha nga i-prepare ang PowerPoint at the same time ang pag-cover sa whole chapter aning atmospheric sciences is because more likely atmospheric sciences is quite broad, no? Okay, we say atmospheric sciences include nato kasagaran dire, no? Ang weather and climate. It's because we are talking about atmospheric, of course, anything that affects or let us say changes or anything kanang mga kalakaran sa atmosphere ato na siyang i-gather or discuss. So by this time, so this will be our outline for chapter 5. So first we have to answer the following questions: what is atmospheric science, then what is weather and climate, what causes weather and climate change. Of course na magina'y changes maski kita, no, experience nato na siya, no. Then what is a meteorological phenomenon, no, napunta'y ginatawag na meteorological phenomenon, which is I will discuss it later, no. Then we have what is a thunderstorm, then what are the phenomena caused by a severe thunderstorm, and what are the phenomena which is not caused by thunderstorm. So by this time, so let us begin, no, for the first part sa tuang chapter 5 to answer what is atmospheric science. And atmospheric science, okay, it is an interdisciplinary field of study that combines the components of physics and chemistry that focus on the structure and dynamics of the Earth's atmosphere. So, na-discuss naman nato prematurely ang ato ang atmosphere from the beginning of the school year class dito sa chapter 1. So, wala kahit ta nag-detail discuss about sa atmosphere. So, we're in fact, anyway, mag-discuss ta about later that. So we have atmosphere na nasyay different types of layers, no, atong atmosphere. But okay, so by this time, so let us answer or let us continue. So by this atmospheric sciences, we also make use of mathematical tools such as differential equations, no. Kung if you are trying to pursue, no, the course of atmospheric science, so magamit niya ang differential equations, mga applications niya, no. Then the vector analysis and computer systems are used to evaluate the physical and chemical relations that describe the workings of the atmosphere. So, nganong differential equations is because there's such cases nga ang ato ang kuan nato ang change manggood sa ato ang let us say weather or climate na siya tendency nga mura siya parabolic. So, if we say parabolic, so naman tayo equations for parabola. Then, naatay mga different types of, kung anong sa base sa study ba, siyang lines, bitaw, no? Okay, so with this case, so differential equation is quite useful, no? Then, if ever man, nga medyo repetitions ang computation sa paggamit sa differential equations, that is why mogamit ta og computer systems, and isa diha is the use of numerical methods, no. Okay, so pangutan-on ko ninyo unsa ang numerical methods. So, agian ako na sa kong masterals, no, sa kong masteral. So ang numerical methods is quite kuan siya, no, ang topic covered sa numerical methods is actually about advanced mathematics, no, katong mga matrix, iteration. But since then, kuan man siya, balik-balik naman yung process in order to obtain the value that we need. So that is why dili man na siya makaya o compute by manual. If in case nga taas kayo yung iteration class, so dili niya makaya siya o manual. So that is why magamit ta o computer to compute, no, the value. So pag sa computer na to siya i-process, mas dali siya. It's because ang iteration process is mas paspas, no. Then kuha naman na siya unda loop raman ang iyahang process, no, sa kanang balik-balik bitaw nga process loop raman na siya i-loop. Okay, so kagado gayon sa sige ka iterate nimo makuha gid ang value. So dali ra kay na siya buhaton sa computer pag kuha nimo nanadayng value, no. Okay, so much with this atmospheric sciences. Okay, so let us discuss the atmosphere, no? So which is the primary focus of the study of atmospheric sciences. So unsa dai ning atmosphere di ay? Okay, so atmosphere is, comes from the Greek word which is atmos, meaning vapor, and sphere or the spira, meaning the ball or sphere, no? Spira. Okay, so atmospira. Kuan yang equivalent Greek word, therefore. So, meaning to say, kung literal na to siya by word, so that is vapor sphere, no? So, anton sa gihimo siyang atmosphere. So, it is a layer or set of layers of gases surrounding a planet or other material body that is held in place by the gravity of that body. So, what makes this atmosphere class is ang sulod sa atmosphere, dili lang kuan class ha. Sa atmosphere class, dili lang oxygen ang ato ang libalan ra mga nato kasagaran pag atmosphere, oxygen, no? Tapos carbon dioxide. Well, daghang klaseng gases, no? Nga naa sa atmosphere. So, dili na siya manganlan tanan. But as you can see, kanang makita ninyo nga gases sa kining sa periodic table, okay, naa diha, present pod ang mga gases na diha sa atmosphere, no? Okay. But in some cases class, when it comes to quantity, moreover, kitong na-discuss na ko itong sa chapter 1, na ako i-indicate ito nga mga number or let us say, mga primary na ay daghang volume of air, no, sa atmosphere. Ngayon na ito, let us say nitrogen, oxygen, some parts of carbon dioxide. Okay, so kana siya mga kinds of gases class, sometimes some of it gi-emit siya sa kanang volcanic eruption, no, especially katong mga sulfur, no? Daghan pang klaseng gases, no. Okay, so balik ta, so an atmosphere is more likely to be retained in a gravity it is subject to its high and temperature of the atmosphere is low. Now, kabalo mo class nga each gases or let us say each masi gas pa na siya, nagyapon na sila ay atomic mass, no? And that atomic mass, ginabira, since nga ang gases, naa na sila atomic mass, naa sila weight, ginabira na sila through the gravity, gibira sila by means of gravitational force, no? Sa Earth. So, that is why, nga, kung makita ninyo, most of these gases mag-retain siya, no? So, dili siya mo escape sa ato ang atmosphere. Okay. So, although, nga, gawas aning atong atmosphere class is kuan na siya space, no? As we know, ang space is vacuum. So pag vacuum, mura siya mo absorb siya og hangin. Okay. So but because of the presence of gravity class, magpabilin ang mga elements of gases dito sa atmosphere, no? So ma-retain lang siya. Okay. So those layers are from the lowest to highest elevation. So, troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. So, muna siya, makita ninyo siya sa figure, no? So, naatay troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. Each of this one class na sila ay kanya-kanyang elevation sa ilahang layer. So, asa na to makita ang atuang ozone layer? So, the ozone layer can be found na siya sa may between sa troposphere and stratosphere, no? Now, those boundary between the troposphere and the stratosphere, we can call that one as tropopause, no? Tropopause ang nasa layer which is between sa troposphere and the stratosphere. Now, unsa man ang layer between stratosphere and the mesosphere? That is stratopause. Then next is sa thermosphere, mesopause, no? Basta ka ng kuan, mesopause. Okay. So, murag ka ng ending sa boundary sa ending sa layer ba, no? So, ending sa layer sa troposphere is tropopause. Sa stratosphere, stratopause, no? Okay. So, right now, so the ozone layer is somewhat na siya sa 20 to 30 kilometer. Then the Kármán line, so wala kay koy kuan background about sa kuan na, no? Fail to discuss about the search for about the Kármán line, no? Then the exobase, Okay, so kuha lang gikwa na ko is the each of this layer. Anyway, mag-discuss tal detail ani, no? So what is a troposphere? Therefore, okay, the troposphere is the lowest layer of the Earth's atmosphere. So mo na siyang atmosphere o a layer sa atmosphere nga mo ay pinaka baba, no? Which is di nato makita, no? Kasagaran ang atmospheric activities, no? Such as kanang mga kwan, kanang mga clouds ba, no? Di nato makita. So the troposphere is the lowest layer of the Earth's atmosphere and it's also where nearly all weather conditions take place. So mo na siya, no? Kung gi-mention all types of weather conditions. So it contains 75% of atmosphere's mass and 99% of the total mass is water vapor and aerosols. So the word troposphere is derived from the Greek tropos means turn, no? Turn toward or change, and sphere as in the earth. So reflecting the fact that rotational turbulent mixing plays an important role in a troposphere structure and behavior. So, dire sa portion sa troposphere class, dire mahitabo tanan, no? So, basis sa kadungkuan, dire tanan mahitabo ang mga weather conditions. Tanan mga klase-klaseng changes sa itong weather, weather conditions. So, most of the phenomena associated with day-to-day weather occur in the troposphere. So, tanan daw klase nga phenomena. But in some cases class, maabot mo siya sa troposphere. So, as a stratosphere. Okay, so next is, okay, let us discuss about the atmospheric flow in the troposphere. So the flow in the atmosphere generally moves in the west to east direction. So ang ato ang flow, no, sa ato ang atmosphere. So the zonal flow regime is the meteorological term meaning that the general flow pattern is west to east. Then along the Earth's latitude lines with weak short waves embedded in the flow. So, zonal flow ang tawag nato pag ang yahang general pattern is from west to east, no? Okay. Along with the latitude lines. Diba? Ang latitude lines mo na siyang horizontal. Okay. Next is meridional flow, which we call that one as the atmospheric. That's more on longitudinal. Meaning to say, pa vertical, no? Okay, longitudinal direction, which an amplified through of low and high pressure that makes it more on north-south flow and general pattern. Okay, unsa man ni silang mga kinds of flow? Mo ni silang flow sa hangin class, no? Okay, so pag ang yahang direction niya, okay, atong i-recall, kung ang yahang direction niya is from west to east, so that is zonal flow. Then pag pa vertical from north south nga flow direction is meridional, no? Meridional direction. Okay, next we have the stratosphere. So mo ni siya nga to ang next layer. So the stratosphere is the second major layer of Earth's atmosphere, just above the troposphere and below the mesosphere. Okay, so na siya sa tunga between the troposphere and the mesosphere nga layer. So the stratosphere is stratified layer in temperature with warmer layers higher and cooler layers closer to Earth. So this increase of temperature with altitude is a result of absorption of sun's ultraviolet radiation by the ozone layer. Okay, so next, temperatures range from the average of negative 51 degrees Celsius or let us say 60 degrees Fahrenheit, negative 60 or 220 Kelvin near the tropopause to an average of negative 15 degrees Celsius near the mesosphere. Okay, so ang atuang stratosphere class is medyo bugnaw siya, no? Nga type nga stratosphere. So, kung bugnaw siya, more likely, hindi rin may tabo itong kuha, no? Kadong ice crystals o kanang magkuhan siya, no? Kadong, at least, I think, murag nakakita mo sa portion sa kadong first nga Iron Man nga movie. Nga kadong nilupad si Iron Man bitaw padong taas. Tapos, pag-abot niya sa taas is na ice build up siya hang suit, no? Tapos, ni kuha ng iya hang suit. Kanang ni namatay ang iya hang suit. Okay. So, nag-shutdown, no? Nag-shutdown. Tapos, nag-kwan siya, no? Nabira siya sa gravity pababa. Okay, so magganik na ulyan. So it means class nga as you go to the stratosphere, okay, so magkuan siya, magbuild siya og ice, no? If ever man nga kuan siya, baba man siya temperature, negative 51, no? Negative 51 to negative 15 degrees Celsius. Okay, below zero. Okay, dali ra kay ka maayos ani. Okay, next. Okay, the border between the troposphere and the stratosphere, which is known as the tropopause, marks where this temperature inversion begins, no? Now, kini makita niyo dito sa figure class is the ano, ang iyahang temperature. So, gikan from the troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere. Ang iyahang variation sa iyahang temperature, no? So, altitude versus the temperature. Okay, so the stratosphere is a region of intense interaction among radiative, dynamical, and chemical processes in which the horizontal mixing of gaseous components proceeds much more rapidly than thus vertical mixing. Okay, so naadaw diha may tabo ang mixing or processes of gases, no? Okay, katong mga types of gas nga which is more lighter than the oxygen, no? Okay. So makaabot ra po diya sa stratosphere or mesosphere katur po mga gases nga mga baba kay sila og weights, no? Okay. Next. Okay, the mesosphere. So the mesosphere from the Greek, which is what we call as the middle, no? Mesos, meso. Okay, is a third layer of the atmosphere directly above the stratosphere and directly below the thermosphere. So that which means that the mesosphere is between the stratosphere and the thermosphere. So in the mesosphere, temperature decreases as the altitude decreases, no? So as the altitude increases, the temperature decreases, no? So makita siguro niyo diri, ah. Okay, as the mesosphere is increasing as the mesosphere is increasing its altitude, okay, the temperature ibaba siya, no? So pag dire lower temperature, pag padong dire higher, no? Mean to say pababa yang temperature as the altitude went high, no? Okay, so muna siya sa mesosphere. So this characteristic is used to define its limits. It begins at the top of the stratosphere, sometimes called as the stratopause, and ends at the mesopause, which is the coldest part of the mesosphere, Earth's atmosphere, with the temperatures below negative 143 degrees Celsius. So grabe kay katugnaw class, no? Diri dapita sa may mesopause na dapit, no? Which is the boundary of the mesosphere, no? Okay, so which is colder than the stratosphere. Okay, stratosphere, mga average niya is naraman sa mga negative 15 degrees Celsius. But dire, sa mesosphere, na, that is negative 143, no? Take note, below zero na siya, no? Sub-zero. Okay, next. Sa mesosphere class, unsa may mga events na mahitabo dire sa mesosphere. So, within the mesosphere, temperature decreases with the increasing height due to the decreasing absorption of solar radiation by the rarefied atmosphere and increasing cooling by carbon dioxide radiative emission. Okay, so medyo technical ra kay class, no? I don't know how, or let us say giyon sa nila pag-explain about this one, but anyway, deal it with the experts, no? Okay, medyo kuan kay technical ra kay sa tuwa para sa dun. Okay, so with this mesosphere, most of the phenomena happen here in the mesosphere. Okay, so muna siya, no? The air glow, atmospheric tides, ionosphere, meteors, nacreous clouds, noctilucent clouds, polar aurora. So muna siya, no? Kanang makita na to sa image, nga kanang makita na to sa sky, nga mag-green-green, no? Kanang maglupad-lupad na green. Nga uban mura daw ungo, no? Or kanang espiritu or kalag, or uban kanang mga hilig og kanang Final Fantasy, no? Live stream daw, live stream. Okay, dili siya ingon ana. Okay, so that one kanang makita nato nga mura siya og kalayo nga naglupad-lupad sa taas nga color green. So that is what we called as the aurora borealis, no? Okay, so upper atmospheric lightning. Okay, So let us discuss about the aurora borealis, no? So aurora are the result of disturbances in the magnetosphere caused by the solar wind. So na-discuss man nato sa itong previous chapter class about the magnetosphere, no, the magnetic field of the earth, and about the solar wind. So the purpose of the magnetic field of the earth is to unsa man iyahang i magsilbi siyang shield, no, para sa ato ang sa ato ang solar wind, no, para dili nato maabsorb dayon diretso ang kainit, no, let us say singaw nga gi kuan singaw nga kainit which is gi emit sa sun. Okay, now kung naay disturbances mahitabo class, ang resulta ana mo ni siya, no, aurora borealis, no. Okay, these disturbances are sometimes strong enough to alter the trajectories of charged particles in both solar wind and magnetospheric plasma. So the resulting ionization and excitation of atmospheric constituents emit light of varying color and complexity. So the form of aurora occurring within bands around both polar regions is also dependent on the amount of acceleration imparted to the precipitating particles, no. Actually wala ni dili ni siya sa kuana. Naron ni siya ang kining aurora borealis, naron ni siya sa layer sa mesosphere. So wala ni siya nahitabo sa atoang kuan, sa atoang troposphere sa may baba, no. So na task nanan siya sa mga layo na ni siya sa atmosphere, no. Okay, so precipitating protons generally produce optical emissions as incident hydrogen atoms. We know hydrogen is much lighter, no? So muna siya, makita ginato siya sa mesosphere. So after gaining electrons from the atmosphere, so proton auroras are usually observed at the lower latitudes. So as you, okay, to summarize it up, no? So aurora borealis is the result of the disturbances of the magnetosphere caused by the solar wind. So naay kuno disturbances. So mo nang resulta. Okay, so let us go to the next layer, which is next to the mesosphere, and we call that one as the thermosphere. So the thermosphere is the layer in the Earth's atmosphere directly above the mesosphere and below the exosphere. So within this layer at the atmosphere, ultraviolet radiation causes photoionization or photodisassociation of molecules, creating ions. The thermosphere thus constitutes the larger part of the ionosphere. Okay, unsa naman po ni ionosphere? Okay, so base sa mga pagkakita class, ang ionosphere is somewhere located at the thermosphere and the exosphere nga part, no. Okay. So thermospheric temperatures increase with the altitude due to absorption of highly energetic solar radiation. So karon class, siguro mo ning gitawag ni nga thermosphere is because dire dapita ang medyo mas init nga temperature compared to the mesosphere nga which is bugnaw, no. Okay, so radiation causes the atmosphere particles in this layer to become electrically charged particles, enabling radio waves to be refracted and those be received beyond the horizon. So delikado para sa tao class nga moabot ta sa thermosphere, no. So dili ta pwede dire is because ang radiation. Sa radiation pa lang or sa kainit pa lang, no, sa temperature patay na ka. Siguro og mo travel pa lang gani ka gikan sa troposphere up to this layer sa kuan nagay ka, baraho nagay ka sa kuan gani stratosphere. Sa stratosphere is na asin average nga temperature which is negative 15 degrees Celsius. So dili siya pwede pang skydiving, no. Okay. Sa stratosphere pa lang gani, no. Then sa mesosphere unsa na lang ka, no, which is negative 143. Correct me. Negative 143 Celsius ba to? Negative, no. Okay. How about sa thermosphere which is more likely taas ya kayo temperature than we used to be in the land, no. Then at the same time naapay mga radiation, no. Okay. So the thermosphere is inhabited with the exception of the International Space Station, which orbits the Earth within the middle of the thermosphere between 408 and 410 kilometers. So dire daw sa thermosphere natawag na to siya nga inhabited, but Dire po nila gina station ang ilahang mga satellites, no? It's because murag abundant man pud ang atoang thermosphere dire dapita og kuano energy that is coming from the sun, no? The solar energy, no? Solar radiation. So mo nang ilahang kuan nila class, ilahang satellite is more likely solar powered, no? Okay. So dili lisod makaipon og energy from the sun. Next is the exosphere. Now technically class, ang exosphere is nanani siya more likely gawas na sa Earth, no? Or let us say the outer space na gini siya. But okay, to define the exosphere. Okay, so exosphere meaning to say from the Greek word exo, which is outside, no? Or external, beyond. So meaning to say this is the exosphere is the outside, no, of the atmosphere. So atmosphere like volume surrounding a planet or natural satellite where molecules are gravitationally bound to that body, but where the density is too low for them to behave as a gas by colliding with each other. So kuan siya class, no, it's more likely na siya yung mga molecules sa to ang exosphere, but there are too much, no? Murag kuan ba kanang dako kay sila og daganan, no? So murag okay, so libit na lang sa ilaha, no? So the most common molecules within Earth's exosphere are those of the lightest atmospheric gases. So hydrogen is present throughout the exosphere. It's because we know hydrogen is the lightest element, di ba? So possibly siya, pwede siya moabot sa exosphere. So with some helium, then we have the carbon dioxide and atomic oxygen near its base, no? So may near its base, which is more likely na siya sa may thermopause, no? Nabawi thermopause. Okay, so naa siya sa may portion sa boundary, no, sa thermosphere. Okay. So now, next, let us proceed to the next, no, which is what is weather and climate. No? So, actually, muna siya nga to ang main discussion about this one. That is why kinanglan nato mo discuss about the atmospheric sciences is because of the relevance of the weather and climate na topic. Okay, so let us discuss what is weather, no? So, weather is the state of atmosphere describing the example, the degree to which it is hot or cold, wet or dry, calm or stormy, clear or cloudy. So therefore, if we say weather, it just talks about the condition of the atmosphere, no? Kung ulan ba siya or adlaw, no? Weather condition ba, no? Okay, so the atmospheric condition. But the weather class is kwan lang na siya, no? Ang iyahang duration niya is na lang siya from day to day, no? Short term lang siya nga duration, weather. Day to day lang iyahang ginakuan, forecast. Let us say weather forecasting, it is the application of science and technology to predict the state of the atmosphere for the future time and given location. So, ang nag-study about weather class, ang science nga nag-study about sa weather is what we called as the meteorology, no? So, meteorology is a branch of atmospheric sciences which includes atmospheric chemistry and atmospheric physics with a major focus on weather forecasting. So, kabalo mataklas, no, unsa importance aning weather forecasting sa tuwa, no, from day to day. Especially, kung kita nag-work or nag-eskwela, kinahanglan nato mahibalo kung muulan ba or muinit, no? Kay sometimes, if ever man nga muulan mar o muinit, kinahanglan nato mag-prepare something, kung magdala batag payong, magdala batag raincoat or something, no? Especially sa mga nag-travel, katong mga naay motor, naay mga kotse, ako may problema ang kotse, kina may atop. So kadto lang mga naay nang motor, no? Then sa kanang mga mamangkaay, no? Kana bitong mga fisherman, no? Sa dapit sa baybay, kinahanglan nila mahibalo ang ilahang kinahanglan nila og weather forecasting kay kinahanglan la may balo nga kung kanos magpalaot, no, kay just in case o palaot sila nga naaday incoming day nga bagyo, no, so ingon na. Then isa pa sa kanang sa mga let us say sa airport, no, sa kanang sa eroplano, so kinahanglan nila may balo ang weather forecast, no, k kay basin og naay bagyo, ya, tapos nilupad sila og eroplano, disgrasya na inuod, no? Similar rapod na siya sa barko, no? So dili sila magpalaot og barko, especially sa katong mga sima, no? Laing kay kita man ta sa kanang mga salida, no, kanang may barko, tapos niya ini kuan sila og kanang tremendous nga weather, mura sila giuyog-uyog gilang kuan, tapos hangtod sa na natumbay lang barko, nalunod lang barko, no? Wala lang nalunod ang tao. Okay, so next, that is the weather. And let us go to the climate. So unsay nakalay-an sa climate og sa weather? By the way, unahon na natong climate. So climate is a long-term average of weather. So typically average between over a period of 30 years. So matawag na to siya climate if it is a long-term. Although similar siya sa weather, but long-term ang climate. Compare na to sa weather class, ang weather is short-term lang siya, no? Muna kung gimension ganihan, no? Which is day-to-day lang siya, no? Let us say, Lunes, Martes, Lunes, muulan, pagka-Tuesday, muragdili, muulan, tapos Wednesday, muulan gamay, muna na, no? So that is weather, no? Sa climate is more likely 30 years, no? Kung gusto ay nausab, on that 30 years, what happens sa, let us say, ang iyahang kwan manggod, iyahang cover scope anay sa climate class is about continental scale, no? Unsa ipilay temperature or global scale or global temperature within those 30 years, no? Unsa changes? Pag let us say for example, pag i-monitor nimo ang temperature sa globe, ibutang nato nga ni-increase ang yahang temperature. So naa gyoy climate change nga nahitabo, no? Okay, so ang climate change class dili na siya bag-o. So gikan pa sa una na ana nahitabo, no? Kitong sa panahon pa daw sa mga dinosaur, no? Okay, so in broader sense, climate is the state of the component of a climate system which includes the ocean and ice on the earth, which is more likely nga mo'y maka-affect sa ato ang climate change, no? The ocean and the ice, no? The condition. Kaya ang ocean class, muna siya'y mo-absorb, no? Sa temperature, no? Capable ang ocean mo-absorb ang temperature. And the ice can also alter the pwede siya murag panguntra sa ato ang init, no? Kaneng ice. So that is why if ever man nga sobra ra pod kayo ang init nga na experience sa earth or sa globe, okay, posible nga ang ato ang ice nato murag ma-melt siya o kapaspas, no? Okay. So at the same time pag ma-melt siya o kapaspas sa atong ice class, posible nga mo increase pod ang volume sa ato ang ocean. Okay, so mo nang importante gyud nga kinahanglan nay mag-study sa ato ang climate, no? Okay, so the climate of a location is affected by its latitude, terrain, and altitude, as well as nearby water bodies and their currents. So, ang science nga nag-study about the climate is what we call as the climatology. So, from the Greek word klima, no, or which is literally mean which is place or zone, no. Tapos okay, let us say the climate science, no? It is regarded as a branch of atmospheric sciences and a subfield of physical geography, which is one of the earth sciences that includes also the aspects of oceanography and biochemistry. So, ngano kinanglan nato apilon ang biochemistry is because isa pod sa mga nakahatag pod o climate change class is ang ato ang biosphere. So, unsa man po ng biosphere, sir? Dagan na kahit ang atmosphere. Okay. So, the biosphere is, it talks just about the volume of, the volume of such as, volume of kwan ba? Kanang na life ba? Kanang such as plants, trees, nga mag-provide o kanang oxygen, no? Okay, dili wala tay labot, ambot labot ba ta literally sa ato ang biosphere, but more likely ang ilang gi-refer sa biosphere nila is more likely katong vegetation sa earth, no, nga nag-provide siya og oxygen. Pag magkuan siya class, mag-provide siya og oxygen class, moto na mention nato ni siya sa ato ang previous nato nga chapter nga the more nga daghan ta og biosphere or kining kining daganta og trees or vegetation, possibly nga daghay magproduce og oxygen. And those oxygen, pag mo-reach siya dito sa atmosphere, mag kuan siya, no? Mag-ionize siya and it becomes O3, no? Mahimo siyang imbis nga O2, mahimo siyang O3. And that O3 will become the ozone layer, no? So I don't know yun sa nila pag-explain ganong nahimong ozone layer ang O3, no? Okay, that is the ionization sa atuang atmosphere, ang ozone layer. And that ozone layer mao na siya mo protect sa tua, sa tuang, okay, mao na siya mo protect sa tuang excess, no? Excess radiation, no? Solar radiation. Okay. So muna, no? Sa tuang climatology. So isa daghan kay sila gina-consider, no? Nga which is more likely that affects the climate, no? Na long term, gikan, no? 30 years. Okay, so meteorology versus climatology. So makita na nato, I think murag na summarize na ako, no? So this one class, kining image above is an example of weather forecasting or the weather itself, no? With local weather. So ang iyang kwan na class, ang iyang cover lang niya or scope niya is na lang siya short term, no? Either week, days. But if we say climatology, naagin siya sa long term na duration, tracing the global temperature, no? Sa kwan pa, no? Taas-taas siya nga period. Okay, both meteorology and climatology are atmospheric sciences. Meteorology can be microscale or mesoscale. So, microscale covers the study of atmospheric phenomena within 1 kilometer range, while mesoscale covers a range of 1 to 1,000 kilometer. And a vertical scale starts from Earth's surface to tropopause, boundary between troposphere and stratosphere. So the meteorology comes with a wide varieties of applications such as weather forecasting, aviation, agricultural. So moto na na siya weather forecasting, aviation, agricultural. Then hydrometeorology, nuclear, maritime, military, environmental, and for renewable energy. So daghan kay siya kuan, daghan kay siya application, no? Ang ato ang meteorology, daghan kay siya gamit, tapo kay siya gamit. Okay. So in contrast to meteorology, so which is the climatology, focuses on a short term, no? Okay, mali man yata ni. In contrast to meteorology, tama day, murag kuan siya, no? Siyahang meteorology. So the meteorology focuses on a short term weather systems lasting up to few weeks. Climatology studies the frequency and trends of those systems in a long term. So climatologists study both the nature of climates, local, regional, or global. So, and the natural or human-induced factors that causes climates to change, no? So, climatology considers the past and can help predict future climate change. Okay. So, okay. Kung i-kuan ako siya class, ihatagan ako comparison for me, ang weather and climate. Ang climate class, kung i-consider na to, no, ang usa ka picture frame, picture na naka-frame ba, that is the climate. Pero if you look into details sa ato ang picture, that is the weather, no? So therefore, ang weather class is the details, whereas ang ato ang climate is the whole picture, no? Okay, in order for you to see the whole picture, you have to view it in a long term, no? Long tungkol sa layo. But if you go into a shorter, you go into the details, no? But sa tuwa class, kung gusto nimo makita ang kausaban yun for a long term, you have to choose the climate, no? Compared the weather. Kasi sa weather man good, kuha naman siya, gamay ra man kayo na, no? Tanaw nimo siya as a whole, gamay ra kayo ang kausaban sa weather, no? So that is why in details man good ang weather. Okay. So what matters most is the climatology. But if we use it for day-to-day lives, we use the weather. Okay. So what causes weather and climate to change? No, kabalo na magita, no? Unsay makapa-change ana niya? Now naturally class, ang atong weather change based on the natural cause, no? But in some cases, because of the increasing population and demand of human activity, so naka-isa punta no, sa mga naga-contribute og weather change. But, okay, but naturally, if we discuss it naturally, kung unsay natural causes aning weather na to, so isa sa mga primarily cause aninya is due to the air pressure, temperature, and moisture sa tuang atmosphere. So differences between from one place to another. So the sun's angle also, no? Ang angle sa tuang sun. And the earth's tilted axis, kadong tilt bitaw, discuss na to sa tong chapter 1 yata to, contributes primarily the change as well as earth, as the earth's hydrosphere cycle and the wind directions topographically. So as you might recall class, ang katong earth's tilted axis and the sun's angle nag-contribute to siya nga na mag-change ang atuang weather, no? So mo nang naatay season. Okay. Mo nang naatay tag-ulan, naatay tag-init, naatay summer, no? Okay. Then the rest is normal, no? Okay, so mo to siya. Ang ato ang mga condition nato sa Pilipinas is tag-init and tag-ulan, no? The summer and the rainy season. Okay. So weather change can be modified, and one of the most successful attempts was the process of cloud seeding. So mo ni siya isa sa mga revolutionary changes, no, or modification nga nahimo sa tao ang kaning pag cloud seeding, no. Okay. So just in case class, if the certain area experience a low precipitation, so isa sa mga answer ini is the cloud seeding, no. Okay. For the purpose of kana bitong agricultural, no. Okay, kasagaran man gud kanang na ay famine. Okay, especially itong mga sinauna sa sinaunang mga tao sa una pag maka-experience lang famine, wagin sila mahimo. But because of this technology of today, so possibly na nga in case og wala nay ulan-ulan ang usa ka certain area, pwede nila paulanon by means of cloud seeding. Okay. And some various techniques of enhancing winter precipitation over mountains and suppressing hail. So just in case, no, kung naay banta sa pag-ulan og hail, no, kabalo man ta unsa nang hail, kana bitaw mag-ulan og ice. Okay, nabalita gani sa Facebook nga ang Maragusan giulan daw og ice, no. Kahapon ba to? I don't know. Okay. So giulan daw og ice, but ang sa uban naghatag sila og mga meme, mga memes, no, nga literal yun nga ice nga gikan sa ref. Okay, so nata explanation ana nganong na ay pagulan og hail, no, sa tuang further discussion about this one. Okay, so ma-suppress nila ang hail, no, by this weather modification made by us, no. So mo na siya nga tuang remarkable nga nahimo, no, which is dili man pud siya kuno, dili man pud siya daotan, no. Okay, so dili man nato gusto nga makuanta, maka-experience og kuan, no, hail. Kaya ang hail man gud kuan man gud na siya, no, pag maigo ka og bula sa ice or let's say hail, bukol gyud ka, no. Okay. Kay na usahay na hail nga sobra kadako nga ang iyang ihulog mura siya kumo, no. Okay, so na uban mura rag hulin. Okay, mo tag hulin lang kadakon, pero kun saan man lagog dako kayo nga mura nagkumo. Okay, perting gubaa si mong atop, no, especially katapong mga naikutsi, no, mura gibato imong kutsi. Okay, una na, no. Okay, so causes of climate change. So climate change is the variation in global or regional climate over time. So most notable causes of climate change over a period of time were, okay, the strength of the sun. So kung mapansin ninyo class, may experience, I think more na experience siguro ninyo, nga lahi rang kainit sa una sa sun o karon, no. Karon makita na may mabati man nimo nga medyo mas init kayo karon ang condition karon sa sun compare sa una, no. Sa una kay medyo makayaman, no. Karon kay mura na mamamaak ang kainit, no. Okay, so lahi ra gyud, no. Aminaw nato murag nagkausab gyud ang sun, no. Okay. Shifting of Earth's orbit, axial tilt and precession. Now to tell you class about the axial tilt. Okay. ang kanang kuan class ang orbit sa Earth or let us say ang kanang bitong location siyang north og south pole, no? Ang kuan niya, tilt niya, nagausab na siya, no? Dili na siya permanente, no? So night tendency nga lagi shifting nga may tabo, no? Now because of the shifting class, we experience pud ta og changes sa weather, no? Now as a whole, makita na to nga mag base niya for a long term, makita nimo nga naagi may tabo nga climate change due to shifting of Earth's orbit. Then the quantity of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere, then okay, daghan ko ano, daghan pag mga cause, no, sa tuang nganong na ay climate change, no. Isa pa diha, no, kang ocean currents and carbon dioxide content, then plate tectonics and volcanic eruption. If there is a frequent volcanic eruption, kabalo na mo class, no, kung unsay epekto sa volcanic eruption. If ever the volcano mag-emit siya og gases and certain kining ashes, no, nga i-suspend niya sa atmosphere, posible nga i-block niya ang sun, no? I-block niya ang heat sa sun. Now, because of this one class, nga ma-block niya ang heat sa sun, posible nga mo-decrease ang temperature sa planet. Now, kung mo-decrease siya class, posible class nga makasinati ta og winter, no? Okay, kinibaba man na to ang global temperature. So, isa po na sa mga disadvantage pag magdaghan kayo ang volcanic activity, no? Anyway, di man na tumapugan ang volcanic eruption, mabuto magin na siya kung gusto niyang mabuto. Okay, buto lang, pabuto. Okay. Then, the plate tectonics, no? Di po nato na siya mapugan. It's because that is made naturally. So, that is the act of the ground movement sa tuang planet, no? Okay. Then, the percentage of Earth's biosphere, no? So, muna kong gimension ganiha, no? Percentage of Earth's biosphere. So, kung mapansin niyo class, ang Earth's biosphere sa una o karon medyo nagkanam-anam na o kagamay is because ginakonsumo naman sa tao ang mga kahoy, no? Dili, but pasabot nga ginakonsumo, dili nga ginakaon, ha? Ginakuan ba? Ginahimo nilang papel? Illegal laging ba, no? Muna na, biosphere. Which, ang ato ang kuan na to, mga trees, mag-provide sila og kaning oxygen, no? Mag-provide sila og oxygen. So unta na untay tree planting may tabo. And lastly, no, nga mo'y primarily makakos sa ato ang climate change is the meteorite impact. So di lang po ta mag-expect nga naay mubangga nga meteorite sa ato ang planet Earth. Posible nga ma-wipe out ta, no, aning meteorite impacts, no. So far throughout our lifetime, wa pa nahitabo nga meteorite impacts, no? Bangakuan lang siya, meteor showers, no? Nga nahitabo. Well, namay mga kuan, namay mga hulog nga meteorite, kitaro itong mga gagmay lang siya, no? Okay. So, dili lang kuta, mahitabo ni inguna ni kadako, no? Dako kayo ni siya class, no? Okay, kung tanawin ni mo siya sa gawas, mo siya gamay, but this is large kayo, no? Night tendency nga makuan gid, no, matandog gid ang planet Earth. Okay, so the climate change can be described as a one big picture while the weather change are only the details of it. So muna ko na mention earlier, no? Okay, so what is a meteorological phenomenon? Okay, so meteorological phenomenon, it is a weather event that can be explained by the principles of meteorology. So, meteorologist ang more likely maka-explain about this one. Or, if ever kung medyo dili kay siya komplikado ang iyang explanation, makaya na to siya explain. So, it can be physical or optical phenomenon associated in the atmosphere. So, physical phenomenon involves physical properties of matter such as mass, density, volume, pressure, and temperature, and energy, no? Which is potential, kinetic, internal heat, etc. Okay. So, pag one class, optical phenomenon siya. Okay, optical phenomenon are any observable events that result from the interaction of light and matter. Meaning to say, light and matter, anang, na ay light, tapos na siya ay interaction with the substance, or let us say the matter itself, no? Okay, optical, kanang makita lang nato based on the observer's perspective. But whereas ang ato ang physical phenomenon, naagi siya changes, no? According sa yahang physical properties of matter, no? Okay. Now, unsa man tong physical atmospheric phenomenon? So, such as the lightning. So, muna siya, no? Flash of electricity in the clouds. Kapalantan siya lightning. Thunder. Unsa man ang thunder? So, thunder is the sound that is made by the lightning. So, pangunta na, sir, ganong mas paspas man ang anong, kung naikilat, sir, iwit lagi ang dalugdog. Okay. So, kabalo man ta class nga the speed of light is much faster than the speed of sound, no? Okay, so I don't have the exact number of the speed of light and the speed of sound. Okay, pwede na ninyo ma-search ninyo sa kwa, no? Sa inyohang, okay, ma-search ninyo sa Google, no? Pila equivalent speed. So, makita ninyo comparatively, no? Okay, so, dili sila mahug nga sabay ang lightning and thunder. So, mauna gina siya si lightning before ang thunder. Then, we have electrical storms. Then, atmospheric pressure. Na-change sa atmospheric pressure is because of the Earth's gravity, no? Iyahang kwan. Then, next is the wind. So, ang wind na to, variable man na to ang wind movement. Then, the atmospheric humidity also, no? Okay, the amount of water vapor sa atong air. Okay, next is the optical atmospheric phenomenon. So, unsa man ni siya? So, natay tulo class nga matawag na to nga optical atmospheric phenomenon. Makita na to ni siya, no? Kining halo. I think nakita na kung sa una, nakakita ko aning halo, pero kwanto siya, no? Sa moon to siya, no? Ang halo can be produced by the sun or a moon, no? So, those, ang explanation ano yung anong nai-halo is because it is an optical phenomena produced by light, no? Okay, pwede sun or the moon. Interacting with ice crystal suspended in the atmosphere. Okay. So, pag naay ice crystal sa ito ang atmosphere class, tapos naay light, posible nga ma-produce siya og halo. No? Okay. Dati class, nakakita ko aning halo. Okay, based on my experience, nakita ko aning halo gabi eh, no? Tung sa moon bitaw, tung padulong ang bagyong Pablo. Okay, naay halo na itabo ato, no? Okay. Okay, the halo that is created by the moon. Okay. So, kung makita ko aning halo class, nindot kay siya tanawon kay na siya kwan ba? Tapos naay moon, tapos naay nagpalibot siya nga lingin, no? Mura siya rainbow. Next is the light pillar. I think you are all familiar with the light pillar. Uban kay kwanto ni siya, gisumon daw ni siya og counter, no? Okay, katong mga nagatan-aw og Netflix, no? About atong counters bitaw. Okay. So ang light pillar class is actually napuna siya influence of the ice crystals. Yun nga lang, ang light niya is not based according sa moon or the sun, but sayahang local light source, no? Okay, so basahon na to. A vertical beam of light appears to extend above and or below a light source. So, the effect is created by the reflection of light from the tiny ice crystals that are suspended in the atmosphere or that comprise high altitude clouds. Okay, unsa man yung high altitude clouds? Anyway, ako nang i-discuss na to later. Daghan natay discuss nga types of clouds. Okay. So, to produce a light pillar, it should be nga naay ice crystal sa tuwang atmosphere. And to do that, para maka-create siya og vertical light, dapat naay light sa yahang or sa kanang area, no? Dito si nasa kanang mga street lights, city lights, no? Tapos, iyahan ang i-reflect na niya padulong vertically, no? Okay, vertically, iyahan ang i-reflect vertically, and those, the result will be a light pillar, no? So, muna siya. So, well, delete na siya, kwan, ha? Wala na siya, gisumon o kwan, counter. Okay, so muna siya. Then, we have the sandogs, no? So, nganong, unsay, nakasandog sa ano eh, di man siya iro o purma, no? Now, the Sandogs class is actually Halo na siya, no? Pero, yun nga lang, ang Halo is na siya nahitabo pag ang sun is na nasa unto, nga part. Nang taas na ba? Taas na ng adlaw ba? But the Sandogs happen when if the sun or the moon is na siya sa dool sa kaning sa horizon, no? Na siya dool sa horizon. So, a glowing spots around the sun, which is the result of refracting of plate-shaped ice crystals in the cirrus clouds. So, sa to pa, cirrus clouds, no? Ang atuang high altitude niya clouds. So, this phenomena are much more visible when the sun is close to horizon. So, sama sa we mentioned. Okay, the sun dog closest to sun is color red. When farther, okay, color red siya pag closest to sun, no? Ang sandog. Pag nasa sa layo, it will be blue or green. Okay. Next. Okay, we discuss, let us discuss about the common meteorological events such as the clouds, no? Clouds is an aerosol consisting of a visible mass of minute liquid, droplets, frozen crystals, or other particles suspended in the atmosphere of a planetary body of similar space. So, pwede siya, napuni siya sa outer space class, no? Pinili nga outer space. Dili tanan. Ah, outer space. Out, ka na sa other planets, no? Napuni siya present sa other planets, but not all planets na ay atmosphere nga makaproduce o clouds. Okay? So, monis lang upat ka core types of clouds. We have the zero form. Actually, zeros ni siya, no? Zeros nga clouds. So, unsay pagkabalo nato nga zeros ang ato ang nakita nga clouds. Zeros pag okay, ang iyang itsura na niya is kanang linya-linya bitaw, palinya nga formation sa clouds, no? So, the Latin word zero means curl of hair, no? Ulit ta sa mura siya buhok, no? Pa straight. Okay, composed of ice crystals ang kining zero form clouds. So, mo din siya, mo siguro ni siya isa sa mga dahilan, no, nga nagaproduce siya og halo, sandogs and light pillars, no, kay ice crystals. Meaning to say, ang zeros manggod is na siya sa high altitude. Pag high altitude class, posible nga niabot na siya sa mga stratosphere. Sa stratosphere man god is na siya average nga negative 15 degrees Celsius. So possibly, no? Ice crystals, no? Ang iyahang nasa kuan, no? Ang sa zeros. Okay. Cumuloform. So cumuloform, which is actually cumulus ni siya, cumulus cloud, generally detached clouds. They look like white fluffy cotton balls. They are usually dense in appearance with sharp outlines. Now, ang cumulus nga clouds class, kuan ni siya nga type of clouds which is taas og elevation, no? Kuan siya ba pabugdo, no? Okay. Unlike sa cirrus clouds and the other types of clouds. Okay, ang cumulus clouds ang importante niya is palingin-lingin, no? Murag kuan siya, no? Una ni, no? High volume nga klase nga clouds. Next is the stratoform. Ang stratoform or the stratos from the Latin word layer, no? These clouds are usually broad and fairly widespread, appearing like a blanket. So, meaning to say, ang stratos, ang iyang appearance ni niya is somewhat kanang katag, no? Spread ba? Kanang, compare sa cirrus, makita ni mo ang linya. Pero ang kanang stratos clouds, murag, fade ba? Fade, no? Fade ang iyang forma, no? Pa-fade. Okay, murag buhok, pa-fade. Okay. So, that is the stratos, no? Okay, when it comes sa elevation class, pinakataas ang cirrus, medyo baba ang cumulus, ang stratos, medyo kuan lang niya siya. Mas taas-taas lang gamay sa cumulus. Pero ang nakakuan lang ani sa cumulus is taas lang siya og altitude, no? Posible nga ang portion sa cumulus abot taas na siya sa taas nga altitude tapos napoy baba na portion. So kuan siya ba kanang layer ta siya layer ba, no? Okay. Last type nga clouds is what we called as the nimbus or nimboform. So nimbus is the Latin word of the rain, no? Let us say ang nimbus muna na siyang clouds nga dagom, no? Or let us say nanay bagyo, ngit-ngit, no? So the vast majority of the precipitation occurs from nimbo-form clouds, and therefore these clouds have the greatest vertical height. Okay. So to tell you what class, kani siya core types lang ni siya. Pwede ni silang mag-combine. Aga ni cirrocumulus, no? Cirrocumulus combine. So unsay porma ng cirrocumulus? Cirrocumulus mo na siyang ang type kuan siya, cirrus nga pa straight tapos na pa lingin-lingin, no? Kanang mura siya og kanang kuan sa dagat, no? Mura siya balod sa dagat ang iyang porma. Okay. Naputay stratocumulus, no? So stratocumulus meaning cumulus siya tapos gispread siya, no? Gispread siya because of the stratus, katag nga cumulus. Then we have cumulonimbus, which is more likely cumulus clouds nga ngit-ngit, no? Ngit-ngit. Okay. Napoy stratonimbus, nimbus stratus. Okay, kamo na lang ana, no? Kamo na i-discuss different types of clouds, katog yung in details, no? Dagang combination. Okay. Next. What is a thunderstorm, no? Okay, so a thunderstorm is also known as an electrical storm or lightning storm. It is basically a storm characterized by the presence of lightning. Okay, so more likely class, makita na to nga thunderstorm class is made up of clouds such as cumulus and nimbus, no? More likely dagom-dagom yun na siya para makaproduce siya. Kanang kwan ba? Kanang dagom ba? Dagom, no? Dagom nga klase, no? Okay, thunderstorm. So, they are usually accompanied by strong winds and often produce heavy rain. So, and sometimes snow, fleet, or hail. But sometimes, but some thunderstorms produce little precipitation or no precipitation at all, no? Okay. So, muna siya, no? Muna'y kasagaran maproduce sa thunderstorm. It can be strong winds. It can be heavy rain, it can be snow, it can be sleet, or it could be hail. But some thunderstorm, walay na gamay lang, taligsik lang, or walay pagulan. Okay, each year, many people are killed or seriously injured by severe thunderstorms despite the advance warning. So, pag nai thunderstorm class, so, ginakuha na nila, no? Gina-forecast na nila pag nai thunderstorm, na ay maghatag na sila caution na iwas lang sa ta sa pangisda, iwas lang sa ta sa pagpalipad sa aeroplano o pag-travel, no? By means of barko, no? Then, okay. So, while severe thunderstorms are most common in spring and summer, so they can occur at just about any time of the year, no? So, ang ato ang severe thunderstorm. So, severe thunderstorm, balik ko na to, most happen sa spring and summer. Okay, kasagaran bagyo, lala nga bagyo, may tabo during spring and summer. Okay, what are the phenomena caused by a thunderstorm? Okay, phenomena caused by a severe thunderstorm, okay, moto siya, no? Heavy rain such as precipitation, okay, or rain, dayon, baha, no? So, kung tasta-tasta likuan ko, tasta-tasta o kanang volume nga giulan, posible nga na ibaha. So, it is a, ang precipitation glass, it is a liquid water in a form of droplets and that have condensed from atmospheric water vapor and then become heavy enough to fall under gravity. So, kabalo naman to class, nung unsay process ano yung anong nga ay ulan, no? Okay. So, it is a major component of water cycle and is responsible for depositing most of the fresh water on Earth, no? Okay. So, the major cause of rain production is moisture moving along the three-dimensional zones of the temperature and moisture contrast known as weather fronts. Okay. Flood is the product of excess runoff causing soil erosion. So, muna niya siya class, no? Magkita na to sa GIF. Okay. Next. Okay, we have cyclone, hurricane, and typhoon, bagyo, no? Okay, kanyang image class is kuha na siya, itong typhoon Haiyan, no? Typhoon Haiyan or Yolanda. Okay, the term cyclone is used to describe a large-scale rotating air mass with strong sustained winds and heavy precipitation with low atmospheric pressure located in South Pacific and Indian Ocean. Okay. So, ang term hurricane class, ginagamit na siya if it is naa siya sa Atlantic and Northeast Pacific. Okay. So, ang term nga typhoon, gamito na ito na siya pag naa siya sa Northwest Pacific. So, tawag na ito cyclone if it is naa siya sa South Pacific and Indian Ocean. Actually, class, cyclone, hurricane, and typhoon, parehas ang na sila tanan. Lahi lang silang pangalan, it's because of its location. Gets? Okay. Then, the rotation of its one class, counterclockwise if it is in northern hemisphere and clockwise if it is in southern hemisphere because of the Coriolis effect. So, unsa man ang Coriolis effect? Kaya bitong if ever nga magbutang ka kuan class, magbutang ka og let's say kanang nag-table no, kanang table nga pwede mo tuyok, magbutang ka og hulin class, tapos ipamove nimo ang hulin pagawas no, i kuan siya padagano nimo siya straight, then samtang ga kuan gipadaga nimo ang hulin pa straight, gipatuyok nimo agatong table no, tong lingin. So ang yahang dagan niya to class is pa pakurba ang dagan sa katong hulin no. Okay, now that explains the Coriolis effect. Kanang tendency bitaw nga parehas ana bitong kasagaran sa kanang bitong mga sniper no. So ginakonsider nila ng Coriolis effect sa mga sniper, kanang mga assassin ba, kanang musil ba, sniper. So ang tendency magud ana gud pag mapabuto sila ng sniper class, igo nila ilang target, i-consider lang Coriolis effect is because na tendency nga ilang bala hiwion sa hangin, no? Okay. Hiwion sa hangin ba? Kay ang bala lang ba medyo kuan lang ba na siya? Gan-gan lang ba ang bala niya? If ever man nga kusog-kusog ang hangin, posible siya nga ikurba siya sa hangin ang yahang bala. Dili literally nga ang bala may mukurba, ang dinaganan sa bala, no? Moy mukurba. So instead nga maigo ang target, dinhi nun maigo. It's because of this Coriolis effect. Okay, so mo ni siya naitabo direct class no sa bagyo no. So because of the Coriolis effect, nag-change ang ilahang rotation. If it is in northern hemisphere, kay kung makita ninyo kini siya class is ang ato ang kuan nato is naman ta duol sa equator. Kay more likely ang rotation ani siya is na siya sa tropic no, tropic namta sa above zero, above. Okay, mag nata sa above. So ang iyang kuha niya is counter clockwise. Counter clockwise kung na, ikaw nag-observe ka na diri sa land no, nasa baba. Pero kung tanaw nimo sa taas, clockwise siya ang rotation no. Okay, counter clockwise gina siya actually. Okay. So this one class kay example this figure, this is counter clockwise. Kung naaka sa ground. Okay, pero kung tanaw nimo siya sa gawas, it is clockwise. Okay, next. So giun sa pagbuo ang mga bagyo. Kining cyclone, hurricane, typhoon. So tropical storms ang tawag nato ani niya class, no? Okay. So how does it become? Unsa ning tropical storm? Okay, ang tropical storm class, okay, it is a generic term used by meteorologists to describe a rotating organized system of clouds and thunderstorms that originates over tropical or subtropical waters and has close low-level circulation. Now, tropical storm, pasabot ana, mura lang siya o low pressure area, no? LPA, no? Low pressure area. Okay. So dili pa na nato siya technically matawag as bagyo. Okay, matawag nato na siya bagyo pag if the tropical storm reaches a maximum sustained winds of 74 miles per hour or higher. So kung maabot siya og one class maximum sustained winds of 74 miles per hour or higher, now we can classify that one as hurricane, typhoon or cyclone. Okay. Pero kung wa siya kaabot og 74 miles per hour, so kuan lang na siya LPA, low pressure area. Okay. So giun sa pagbuo sa bagyo. So base diri sa kwang glass sa tuang image diriya. So water evaporates from the ocean surface and comes into contact with a mass of cloud air, no, forming clouds. So after the evaporation, pag ma-evaporate ang atuang kwang glass, ang atuang water into water vapor, of course pasaka man gyud siya, no, pa vertical. Now take note, class, high humidity and ocean temperatures of over 26 degrees Celsius are major contributing factors. Pag ma-maintain niya ang iyahang temperature of 26 degrees Celsius, okay, so possibly na siya nga mo'y makaproduce of tropical storm, no? 26 degrees Celsius, mag-evaporate. Then, naman po tayo hangin nga which is moving pa horizontal, no? Okay, so once nga mag-collide na sila, class, ang hangin nga pa vertical o hangin nga pa horizontal, posible sila nga mag-kuan sila, no? Mag-ganang usitaw gani? Mag-rotate ba, no? Okay, so mag-produce sila of column of low pressure develops at the center. So winds form around the column. So mag-kuan siya ba, no? Mag-create siya of column of clouds. Then as the pressure of the central column or the eye weakens, the speed of the wind around it increases, no? Okay. So pag muhinay daw ang speed ang sana when the pressure of the central column weakens, means pag mababa ang iyang pressure, class, sa tunga. Okay. Possibly nga mag-increase ang speed sa iyang palibot. So pag mag-increase na siya, class, muna mag-create na siya og hurricane, typhoon or cyclone. So muna diha na mabuo ang typhoon. Okay, next. Okay, mga severe pinamina caused by a severe thunderstorm natay gitawag nga hail or hailstone. Okay, how to explain nganong naay ice nga giulan? Actually, class, hail is a form of solid precipitation. So wala siya kalayaan sa kanang normal nga pagulan. Yun nga lang solid, no? Okay. Hail is possible within most thunderstorms as it is produced by cumulonimbus cloud. Okay. So giun sa pagsugod ani. Okay, base nato sa tuang kwa na natay figure. Okay. Hailstone starts as water vapor condensing into tinier water droplets. As the temperatures in the middle and the upper parts of the thunderstorm clouds become extremely cold, pag mababa ang temperature, they freeze into small ice balls, no? Okay. So ang tawag na ito, ana, ganing mga small ice balls, we call that one as hail embryos, no? So, growth into a fully fledged hailstone happens in the hail growth zone. So, muna siya, no? Hail growth zone. Now, if ever man, nga ito ang mga hail embryos na ito, magsigi siya collide sa uban pang mga hail embryos, mura sila og nagkuan ba, nagdikit-dikit ba? Okay. Well, the updraft air temperature is negative 10 to negative 25 degrees Celsius. Once they keep on colliding with other droplets and building either size, they now began to fall into the sky. So, nagka-increase man ang iyang volume, nagka-increase po ang iyang weight. So, possibly siya, class, nga mahog na siya sa sky, no? So, that is why nga na ay hailstone mahitabo, no? So, yun sa pagka-produce sa hailstone, if the water vapor condensing into tiny water droplets, mag-solidify siya, no? Na-freeze, no? Na-freeze, nahimong ice, nagagmay. Tapos, nagsigi siya collide with other droplets, nagkatubo, no? Nagkadako ang iyang volume hantod sa kaitong nahimo siyang larger hailstone. So, muna siya. That explains why nga nung magulan taog ice, no? Tungod na po na siya sa temperature sa tuang cumulonimbus cloud. Okay. Next. Okay, lightning and thunder, no? Ganong na ay kilat, no? Tapos na ay thunder, no? Yun sa pagproduce sa lightning sa atmosphere. So lightning will be the product when two opposite electrically charged region of the cloud layer reacts from one another, or a negatively charged cloud will react on the positively charged ground. So this happens when rising ice crystals collides with a dropping gropel or kadong soft hail, kadong hail embryo, no? Ano? So kung ang ice crystals class, ang ice crystals pasaka man, tapos ang dropping gropel, kadong soft hail, gagmay nga hail, pag magbangga na sila class, okay, pag magbangga na sila, magproduce na sila charge, no? Ang kadong ice crystals nga pasaka, pag nabangga na, after niya mabangga sa kadong gropel, mahimo siyang positively charged. Samantalang ang kadong kuan, ang kadong gropel, mahimo siyang negatively charged. So that is why class, sa part sa clouds na ay positive na ay negative, no? So while the gropel becomes negative, okay, so the ice crystals become positively charged and while that gropel becomes negative. So thunder is the sound produced by lightning on its path. That is why we can hear a rumbling sound due to indefinite pattern. Okay. So ang thunder class is a sound, no? Dalugdog. So nga nung medyo rumbling sound siya is because kabalo man siro kata class nga ang lightning na to, ang pattern sa lightning is dili siya straight kundi indefinite pattern, no? Indefinite pattern ang iyahang pan. So, kung indefinite pattern ang iyahang lightning, so indefinite pattern po ang sound nga iyahang maproduce. Okay. Since the speed of light is faster than sound, therefore, light appears first before we hear the rumbling sound effect. Okay. So, nga nung na ay positive and negatively charged. So, moto siya, no? Tungod sa katong katong collision between the ice crystals and the gropel, no? Okay. So dire dapita nga part class, dire sa taas, this more likely makita nato ang katong ice crystals, no? Okay, positively charged ice crystals, no? Then dire is the negatively charged gropel, no? Okay. Now if ever man the negative the positive charged ice crystals attracts with the negatively charged gropel, so magproduce na siya of lightning. Attract siya, psh, ano, diba positive, negative? Okay. So, pag positive, positive, wala yung reaksyon, no? Lalaki, lalaki, may reaksyon. Babae, babae, reaksyon. Lagi yung reaksyon pag positive, negative. Okay. Now, how about sa, okay, kwanto siya, cloud to cloud reaction? Okay, how about from ground to cloud? Okay, possibly na siya class if the ground is positively charged, no? If the ground is positively charged, then the negative charge part sa atuang cloud mo attract na siya dito sa atuang positively charged na kwan. Murang magkakita tag kwan class lightning ang mo struck siya, no? Moigo siya din sa yuta, no? Okay, especially ang kanang kahoy, positively charged ang kahoy. Okay. So, next, that explains why nga na ay lightning and thunder. So, what are the phenomena not caused by a thunderstorm? So, kitong mga phenomena nga not related sa thunderstorm, mo ni siya, no? Avalanche. So, avalanche, more likely, ang dahilan na ni class is siguro loose ang kuan, snow, tapos weak ang iyang layer, no? Then siguro na trigger ni siya by means of mechanical failure, no? Maybe ang naka-trigger niya linog or explosion. Okay, so kuan ba natandog ang iyang loose nga snow, no? So by means of gravity nahulog. So mo nang na ay avalanche. Next, blizzard. Okay, blizzard, it is a severe snowstorm characterized by a strong sustained winds. Now, kaning blizzard class is actually kanini siyang snow, loose nga snow nga gidala sa hangin, no? Okay, muna siyang blizzard. Okay. So, ground snow or loose ground snow nga gidala sa hangin. So, muna ang blizzard. Then drought, so muna siya ang tagtuyot, no? So, drought is the event of prolonged shortage of water supply, whether atmospheric. Okay, below average precipitation, surface water. Okay, since wala may atmospheric activity such as thunderstorm, wala yung thunderstorm, so therefore, drought ang ma-experience, no? So a drought can last about months or years, or may be declared after a few as 15 days. No? Okay, so lala kay itong drought sa nga, especially kanang famine. No? But today, so dili kay siya, kuhaan, class, no? Dili na kay siya problema karon. So ang problema lang nato is kanang mga atmospheric anomalies such as La Niña, El Niño, kanang may ulan na, no? Okay. So, it can have a substantial impact on the ecosystem or agriculture on the affected region and the harm to the local economy. Okay, dust storm and dust devil. So, unsa day ning dust storm? Actually, wala siya kalayaan sa sandstorm. Or let us say, it is a sandstorm itself. No? So, what makes the sandstorm happen? No? Actually, it is a meteorological phenomenon. But this one, it is actually a loose sand. It's just more likely similar siya sa blizzard. Ang sa blizzard, loose snow. Ang dili sa dust storm or sandstorm, it is a loose sand. Nasa sobra kalayt sa sand, nga makaya siya dalod sa hangin, and that hangin, well, saman, yahang dalod niya, i-transport niya ang yuta or let us say ang loose sand or dirt from one place to another. No? Gidala siya abog. Okay, naka-experience po ko aning sandstorm dito diri tong nakuan ko, no, tong naapa ko sa Saudi. So more likely class is ang literal siya, literal good nga kuan god kanang ang sand class dili kay siya kanang kuan bunbon, actually bunbon gyud siya, no, kanang murag pino gyud kay siya nga kuan ba, pino kay siya nga particle sa sand. Na pwede ni mo siya ma-inhale, no? Delikado siya ma-inhale. So, more likely, mo nang, kung makuan ka, maka-agi ka aning sandstorm, usahay zero visibility gud siya, no? Zero. Makita gini mo, mura siya similar sa apog, ang iyahang purma, pero yuta siya, no? Kanang kuan, brown, balas, mo makita. So, naka-agi ko na dito sa kuan, nung nako sa Saudi, no? More likely, pag muagi ng sandstorm, mag-change weather na siya dito sa mga. Na maabotay na ang winter. Okay. So, that is a sandstorm. No? It is a wind that carries a loose sand. No? Tapos, unsa ba yung dust devil? Ano, gitawag man siya dust devil. Okay. Actually, buto, I don't know what makes it gi-call siya og devil. But, dust devil is a strong, well-formed, and relatively short-lived whirlwind. Whirlwind na siya actually, no? Nga nagdala og dust, no? Or let's say sand, no? Then, marang, dili siya similar as the tornado or typhoon nga taas-taas o kinabay. Marang, igo na siya muagi, no? So, ang yahang height niya is more likely half a meter wide or a few meters tall. Okay, so ang kadakwa na niya is more than 10 meters wide or more than 1,000 meters tall. So the primary vertical motion is upward. So dust devils are usually harmless but can on rare occasions grow large enough to pose a threat to both people and property. Okay. So mura siya kanang kwan ba? Alimpo man sa buhok man ang alimpo. Pwede mo na na ba, no? Kanang hangin lang bitaw siya. Habagat. Okay. Habagat bitaw gana. Buhawi, no? Buhawi. Okay. Pero buhawi siya nga nagdala siya og dust. Okay, next. Landslide and mud flow. So common man ni siya. Ang kining landslide and mud flow is more likely kuan ni siya, no? Landmass movements, no? Nani siya sa tuwang erosion. So the term landslide is actually less frequently landslip refers to the several forms of mass wasting that may include the wide range of ground movements such as rock falls, deep-seated slope failures, mud flows, and debris flows. So landslide, pag ang tendency ani class, may tabo lang yung landslide pag ang characteristics sa yuta is nag-change, no? So gikan sa kuan, murag nawala yung strength ba to hold, okay, nawala ang strength sa particle sa soil to hold, no? Pag na weak na siya class, ang tendency na niya mo kuan siya, no? Ang yahang property niya na himong liquid, no? So nag-create siya og landslide or failure siyang strength sa soil. Okay, landslide ang ma-produce. Pero dire sa mud flow, kaya mud flow nahimo siyang nagbehave siya as mura siyang liquid, no? So a mud flow or a mud okay, is a form of mass wasting involving very rapid to extremely rapid surging flow. So of debris that has become partially or fully liquefied by the addition of significant amounts of water to the source of material. Okay. So let us say pag na-liquefied siya, meaning to say na kwan ba, no? There's an excess volume that is present on the portion of the soil. So mo nang nagbehave siya as liquid, no? Mud flow. Ang sa landslide naman nawala ang iyang strength, no? Okay. So nawala yang strength, ulit siya ni humog ang yuta, so nagka-kwan siya, no? Produce siya landslide. Then natay wildfire and fire devil. So kung natay dust devil, napuntay fire devil. So the wildfire or the bushfire, windland fire or rural fire is an unplanned, unwanted, uncontrolled fire in an area of combustible vegetation. Now more likely ang wildfire class, sometimes it is natural or sometimes dili siya natural, it is man-made, no? Or let us say kababayaan or intentional. Okay, kanang usually sa tua class sa mga nitibo ginagamit, ginahimo nila ni nga kuan nga practice kanang magkaingin bitaw for the purpose nga gusto nila himuong fertile ang yuta by means of burning, no? Human og kasunog class sa portion sa area, human nila himo sa kaingin, mga kuan man ma-fertile man daw ang yuta, no, tungod sa mga sinunog nga mga organic nga material, no, such as mga grass, mga unana, no. Okay, but in some cases class ang wildfire, it happens to the during the dry climate, no, especially nauso ra ba tong wildfire tong previous nga mga years, no, katong mga forest daghan duwi kay mga hayop ba, mga wild animals nga nangamatay because of the wildfire. So ang nakakos sa aning wildfire class is the dry climate or kanang kuan ba, sobra kayo nga tagtuyot dira uga. Then ang tendency ana niya class, it can be also triggered by means of lightning, no? Okay, if we say the thunderstorm clouds attracts, no, with the positively charged ground, so magproduce siya og lightning. So magstruck siya og lightning sa atuang trees, possibly siya nga magcreate siya og sunog. Then also it can be done by volcanic eruption. Then by man-made cause, it could be arson, then slash and burn, muna siyang clearing, kanong kaingin, then explosives, no? Okay, so that makes the wildfire. And unsay naka-cause aning fire devil or fire world, no? Whirlwind siya nag-create, whirlwind siya nga na ay fire. Okay, yun sa isang pagka-possible sir nga hangin siya sir, nagdala siya og kalayo. Okay, now actually class, this firewheel or wildfire happens kung naay, kaning fire devil happens only kung naay wildfire, no? Or naay forest fire. Okay, now it happens pag naay fire or let us say naay tornado, no? Tornado or kanang buhawi, no? Wildfire tapos naay buhawi. So mo nang murag kuan ba ang kalayo class nga kanang nag nga na produce during the wildfire tapos gisabayan siya og blow sa buhawi, so mo nang naay tendency nga maka-create siya og fire tornado, no? So it is a whirlwind induced by a fire and often it is least partially composed of flame or ash. So this start with a whirlwind often made visible by smoke and may occur when an intense rising heat and turbulent wind conditions combine to form whirlwind eddies of air. Now sa sulod sa kuan class, sa whirlwind is more likely mura man na siya og pasuyop ang hangin, no? So pasuyop ang hangin. So dili siya mapatay ang hangin, no? Instead mura ginafeed niya ang hangin, no? Ginafeed niya ang hangin until sa magproduce siya og fire, no? Kalayo nga whirlwind, no? So mo na siya. Okay. Now, that's all, no? Para sa ato ang chapter, I guess, no? So, medyo ubay-ubay po na ko ang na-discuss, no? Sa ato ang chapter 5. And medyo nag-text for me, no? To prepare this one. Kaya medyo dako kayo siya scope ang atmospheric science. Then, kinahanglan nimo may balo kung giyon sa pag-produce aning mga phenomena. So, more likely, no? I'm glad nga nahuman nato ning chapter 5. So, on the next installment, so we have the chapter 6, no? So, I prefer to discuss to you the groundwater, no? So, groundwater. Okay. So, this time, so this ends the chapter 5. So, thank you. So, if you have questions and clarifications, you may leave into the comment. And sa katong mga interesado, subscribe, no? Sa tuang channel. Okay. So, thank you and see you next video. Bye-bye.